Hi, welcome to ESP32 tutorial from RoboJax. In this video, we are going to use SunFounder's ESP32 camera extension board to stream video using this camera. Let's get started with this. And the stream will start. The detection is activated. ESP32 starter kit from SunFounder. This is the best ESP32 learning kit from SunFounder. It has this ESP32 microcontroller, which has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. This board can do everything Arduino Uno can do or many other Arduinos can do, plus extra more features. Because we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, the possibilities are endless. You can get connected to the cloud or do the control or read information or values via your mobile device or your desktop or over the cloud from a far location. It comes with a camera extension kit where you can stream the video over Wi-Fi, either through the cloud or to your network. And also it comes with micro SD card where you can save images on the micro SD card, or you can write from the device any information, log the information on the device and read it back. You can power the board using this included 18650 lithium battery. And it has built-in charger where you can connect micro USB and charge the battery. The kit comes with 320 pieces of component that you can learn tons of projects. I have a separate video explaining this ESP32 camera module like this. And it has been viewed over 100,000 times. The link is below the video in the description. But this has nothing much, all the ports have been blocked. You can't do anything, even though it has ESP32 module, everything is there, but you cannot use it. This can be just used for this purpose. But with this, with the SunFounder ESP32 module, there are pins available that you can program and do other tasks. And it comes with a battery. Everything looks very nice and easy to use. And you can stream it, the video over your Wi-Fi network. This tutorial is about viewing or streaming video over the same Wi-Fi network, and the speed of stream depends on your Wi-Fi router. Mine seems to be not that good quality. So my router might not be as good as it's supposed to because the speed is like 200 megabit per second and it's very slow. Let's insert this into the card. We're just pulling this up like this, and because the metal connectors are at the bottom, these shiny wires should be facing down and the camera will be facing up. So we just insert it, make sure it's aligned up to this portion. You see here, it should be almost equal to this, and then press it. Now the camera is facing up. If I hold it, the camera is facing that way. Come to this page, docs.sunfounder.com. Scroll down until you see ESP32. Then click on ESP32 Starter Kit Main. On the left side, click on Arduino User. And here, scroll down until you see 8.2 Camera Web Server. This is the documentation page for today's lesson. And we just need our ESP32 board and ESP32 camera extension board. Attach the camera, which I've shown you in previous lesson. So we can attach it first and connect it and upload this code. And I'm going to explain it. And we have these two settings. Make sure to set these settings, otherwise the camera will not work. And then we have these settings on the browser, which I'm going to show you. I'm opening Arduino IDE. Let's open our project by clicking on File, Open. On the left side, click on Downloads, then ESP32 Starter Kit Main on the right side. double click to open it, double click on C, double click on codes, and on this screen scroll down to IoT number 2, IoT 2 camera server, double click to open it and select the file, open to open it. This is a file. At the top we have ESP camera header file, Wi-Fi. You don't need to install anything once you prepare the Arduino for ESP32. Everything is already included, and this code can work with multiple cameras. The camera, the code that we are using is camera model AI Thinker. As you can see, this is active. So this is the activated line and the camera pins. Don't worry. Here you enter your SSID for the Wi-Fi, and this is a Wi-Fi password. Pay attention, this is DARS, and DARS, D is lowercase. If I put capital D, it will not work. So make sure to respect the case of for the SSID, because uppercase, lowercase will make big difference. Then you don't need to do any other setup. In here, this is the frame size and the format. If I go to on GitHub, I searched for this variable. In here, it has been explained that the format that you can enter is YUV422, grayscale, RGB565, and JPEG. Just search for this on Bing or Google, and then follow the link that goes to GitHub, and you will get a lot of information about this. And here it says configure the frame size 240 by 240 if certain device is selected. This line will get connected to the Wi-Fi, and if it's not connected, this will print continuous dots because it says Wi-Fi status is not equal WL connected. So this will continue until it's connected. Once it's connected, you will see this text on the screen and the IP address after this word, so you know which IP you should get connected to. Now let's see how we can select the ESP32 board. We can click here under the select board and type here ESP32DEV. As soon as you type dev, you will see dev board. You can select it and click OK. So the board has been selected. Now we have to select the port. The other way to select the board is click on Tools, Board, ESP32, and select the ESP32 dev module. Now we have to select the port. If I click here, it shows two ports, and I don't know which one belongs to my device. Sometimes you will not see the number properly. So the best way to be sure, right click on the Start menu, go to the Device Manager, and you will see here the ports. If I click on this arrow, it will show me the ports. One is USB serial CH340, the other is USB serial device. And here, now it's connected. If I disconnect this, one of them disappears. The one that disappeared is my board. So 6 stays and 8 disappeared. If I connect it, so 8 is my COM port, CH340. Now 8 is my COM port, and I can select it. Or I can click on Tool, Port, and here you will see it. You can select whichever you want. Ours is COM 8. Now we have successfully selected the board and the port. And this is very important. It must be done first. Once the code is ready, click here to upload the code to the ESP32. Once it got connected, you will see the IP address here, 192.168.0.100. Now let's open the browser and type HTTP. :/192.168, whatever is the address for yours. Mine is this. And once I clicked, it shows these settings. Click Start Stream. and the video will start streaming here. It will start working. From here you can select the resolution, let's say HD, give it a little time and the stream will start. And from here we can take photo. Now once I clicked, the photo is there. So right click and then save the photo wherever you want. This way you can save the picture and then start stream. It will come back. Let me select a smaller resolution like that so you can see it. And there are a lot of options you can play with this. For example, grayscale, you can make it grayscale, and grayscale would be faster. Maybe sepia, you can do that. Negative. Like that, and no effect. And from here we can do mirror, horizontal mirror, vertical flip as well if the camera is upside down. There are other options like enroll face detection. For example, if I do this, it says it cannot work, so we have to enable face, or we have to reduce the resolution to the lower, like 320 by 240, and then we can enable this, and then now face detection is activated, but we have to enroll the face, and which is not part of our lesson because it needs a lot of other setups. At the moment we don't have face recognition. Maybe Sun Founder will provide a code in the future. Make sure to check their website. And here is a demonstration. I have connected it to the battery. There is no wire or anything. And these are all the settings that you see on the screen. It's available, but the video will be at the bottom. So but just make sure that you connect this. And here is a demonstration. I have entered the IP address for the ESP32. My mobile phone is connected to the same router as the ESP32, and once you see this screen, there is a start stream. Once you touch that, the video will be displayed at the bottom, and the speed of the stream depends on how fast your router is. The router that I'm using for this is not maybe good quality, but this works very well. This camera is much better than this option. The price is very high, and you can get this with 320 other components and learn, plus the camera and other features. And also it has 18650 lithium battery with built-in charger, so you can charge it and carry it and take photo. This is much better than this. I definitely recommend this.